Hello, Porgies.
What's up, YouTube?
Today we're here.
Crack Shack.
Yeah, not known for drugs. Known for their eggs, their chicken. Everything's organic. They have this thing called Jindori Chicken, which is like the Kobe beef chicken. So it should be really, really good. So come check it out. This is my next episode of Munchin Mondays. Crack Shack.
Delicious.
It's very tender and juicy.
Crispy on the outside,
juicy.
And yet still juicy
on the inside.
Flavor on the inside. I ordered the coupe de ville.
Okay.
Fried chicken with lime mayo, coleslaw, some pickles on there. It was delicious.
And then I ordered the Cali dip. It was more of like a sandwich style, and it was a little crispy on the bun, and then you had french fries in it because it's Cali style, like your California burritos.
Uh-huh.
And it was really good.
A little bit of every single sauce. The chimichurri was, I thought it had a little bit, would have a little bit more mint to it, but I mean, it's not as minty as I would have liked, but it was still pretty good. The mustard, I forget what it was called, was very full of flavor. It was very good, all over my sandwich.
And the crack syrup. Was it called crack syrup?
It's not called crack syrup.
I thought it was like crack syrup.
It said crack syrup.
Crack.
It was just ketchup.
It was just ketchup?
Yeah, 9.9.
Not...
Oh, wow.
Because the 0.1, there's actually no crack in it. Highly recommend though, if you like fried chicken.
Follow me at www.happilyevernancy.com and youtube.com/happilyevernancy for beauty vlogging, lifestyle, and fashion videos. So.
And you guys are matching. Woo! Rub the cock. Rub the cock.
It's actually really dusty.
I would say a 9. I don't really like fried chicken, but this place is bomb. My sandwich had bacon and egg and a chicken and fried chicken, so it's like two chickens and a pig. It was good. And I tried the Mexican fries my second time here, and I did like the fries. They have the bocce court. Look at this little girl having fun.
What?
And it's just good because everyone can pay for their food, and you don't have to figure out the bill at the end, so it's good for big groups.
Today on Munchin Mondays, I have a special guest, Shella.
Vince's number one fan. I watch each and every one of his Munchin Mondays.
I would give this place an 8. Just to give a little background, I came here after eating adobo with rice, and I still finished my whole sandwich. I got the Firebird. Really good crispy chicken, and the brioche bun was very buttery, and sauces were really good too. So, 8. It's very hipster. They have valet if you want to be bougie. They have this nice chicken you can take a picture of. They have little lights and lights in the tree. So, if you want to be hipster and take good Insta photos, come here.
Do it! Senor Croquet. That was mighty, mighty delicious. The texture was very full. There was a little crispiness to the chicken on there. They had bacon. Oh my gosh, crunchy bacon, fish no chicken. Who loves crunchy bacon? I love crunchy bacon. And they put a little medium egg in there. The point where you take a bite and the egg yolk just oozes out. That was my goodness. If you come here, you gotta get the croquet. We got the Mexican poutine.
Uh-huh.
The Mexican poutine had their chicken, kind of like carne asada fries, but with a different sort of gravy. And we got the biscuits. The biscuits were very fluffy, very light. They had the jam. It was maple butter. Oh, maple butter, you're right. It was maple butter. Butter with it. I could not taste the maple, but it tasted very buttery. If you come here, I'll give it about an 8.5. Come here, it's good. The ambiance is very, very, it's not too loud, but it's loud enough. You can still hear each other if you're across the table. And it's beautiful. Look at this lit up tree.
His brother is not
It's two lights in my life.
Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe. And as always,
click, click,
be marvelous.
Check out my big cock.
Oh.